Good afternoon to all of you. So just wait for some time as I am doing the setup and then we will start our lab class. Okay, just give me some minutes and then we will start.
Okay, good afternoon to all of you. So first, before starting our classes, I want to know that how many of you have Linux is installed in you or using any VirtualBox, anything? Means those who have, then they can raise their hand so that I can know that yes, these people have at least the OS with them. Or if no one else, then we will act accordingly. So only I can see Sumit have raised his hand. The Jay Prakash Kumar. Ritik Chatterjee. So means very few have Linux actually with them. I can see. Okay, fine. Okay, actually I have an issue with my Linux in one system. So I am trying to reinstall it and taking it some time. So that's why it is a bit delayed actually, we can say. So before starting our session of lab actually, so today what we are going to do, we are going to check some commands, that commands available with us. We are going to check those particular commands, how to work on that command, how the commands actually goes on. We will see those particular things, right? Now, okay, just a minute. Oh, I need to log in with my Linux. Join a meeting, password is 719. Hello.
So, am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so now I have a setup and I am logged in with Linux. Just okay. Now it's fine. Okay. So, first I would like to show you that how the Linux actually looks. Okay. Means my window, wait a minute, so I hope you people can see the Linux interface actually, right? Actually this is the interface of Ubuntu, so you people can visualize the interface of the Ubuntu, right? So this is something different from our Windows. So in Windows it is something different, and in Linux the interface are totally different. So if we click right, if we have a right click on our mouse, so So we can see the options that are different from our Windows, right? In Windows, we have the refresh option. We can create several options there, but in Linux, the options are different. So the interface are totally different with respect to Windows. So that's why it is totally a different thing we can talk about. And that I have talked to you people previously that the thing is terminal. Whatever we do in our Linux, that is totally from this particular terminal, right? So we can see that there is a thing black. This is called, we can see the name terminal. So this is our terminal from where the things we will going to do, right? So this is our terminal. And we have our options for something like this. From the left side, we have the option and we are going to activate whatever we are want to do actually. So these are the things by which we want to actually connect. Okay.
Okay, just a minute.
So let's proceed with our process. That first we want to visualize our Linux programming that we are going to do. What are the programming or what are the things we are going to do in our Linux lab, right? So let the file open first. Okay. So we can see that, okay, I think these are the outcomes of the laboratory, right? So what after doing this particular lab, what we can learn, what we are going to learn through this laboratory. That first one, we can understand the basic knowledge of the Linux command and file handling utilities. So what are the commands we have learned in our theoretical classes. We have learned some theoretical Linux from in our theoretical classes. So that things we are going to implement in our lab, and file handling utilities, how to manage the files. This can be we are going to learn. Next, the shell script program. The shell script, I have talked to you that what is a shell and how to do a shell programming. We are going to do it. We are going to see it in the laboratory part, right? Then create a directory to change, move, and analyze the process how of a parent-child relationship, IPC mechanism. So these are the outcomes. These are the things we are going to learn through our laboratory part, actually, right? Okay, so now going one by one. Okay, so these are the experiments. These are the things that is in your actually laboratory curriculum according to the JOT, that these are the experiment that is given in your curriculum. And I will share this particular file where the solution was also done, and you people can have it, you people can see it, but I will share it in a later time, not now, not today, because first we will look some, we will go for some these type of topics, and then we are going to see.
So this is the experiment available that to do.
Just a minute, the network is actually down.
Just give me a minute.
I hope you will can see the terminal. So now what we are going to do, first we are going to actually create a directory. First we will go step by step, just going for a simple command. So first we will create a directory, right? So suppose, what is the command? Can anyone tell me what is the command to create a directory? What is the command to create a directory?
Mkdir.
So the command mkdir. So this is my command, mkdir. So just simply write. We can see the dollar sign is there already. So only write the mkdir and then the directory name. Okay. Suppose I want to create a directory csc. Mkdir space the directory name. Only simply, so then enter. Okay, so what it is showing that cannot create directory csc, already file exists. So means already a name along with csc was already there, right? So let's make something else, that mkdir csc 123, right? Now after clicking, pressing the entering button, no actually error is there, right? So mkdir csc 123, we can actually have that. So is this my screen is visible? You can see.
Yes,
no,
sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So mkdir csc 123. Now we want to move from this directory. Now presently we have in a directory of csc lab to @ubuntu. So we can see this is my directory name, right? So now I want to change the directory and shift to newly created directory. The newly created directory means that csc 123 that we have created. Now to change the directory, the command is for cd. Cd is for change directory. Cd csc 123. Then enter. Now look, in the previous line, in this particular line, before cd csc 123, I have written cd. The dollar sign, before the dollar sign, it was in something csc lab 2 @ubuntu, right? But now when I have used this particular command cd csc lab csc 123 and then pressing enter, it has changed to the new line, and now before the dollar sign. Now before dollar, we have a new thing, that is csc lab 2 @ubuntu, then csc 123. So I have changed to get a directory. So this is by simply using this mkdir command, we can easily create a new directory. And by using this cd change directory cd option, we can easily move to the new directory. Right? So fine. So this is basic, that I have now moved to my new directory, that is csc 123, right? And okay, so I have Done what? I have created a directory that is mkdir/cse123. Then I have moved my directory to that cd CSE123. I have changed that change directory to that CSE123. Now I have here is CSE123. I am with in this particular directory, right? Now I want to change back to my previous directory, right? So I was in CSE123 this particular directory. Now if I want to get back to my previous directory, so only the command I need to write, that is cd. So if I write only cd, then it will help us to get back to its previous directory. So three things: mkdir, that is to make new directory, and with the name we just need to put a name. Then to get that new directory, write cd, change directory and the name of that particular directory. And if I want to get back to my previous directory from my current directory, so the command is only cd. So sometimes depending upon the operating software of the Linux version, whether it can be Ubuntu, whether it can be Fedora, depending upon it, this command has slight change. Just like that, you can see that I have first write cd dot dot. Okay, so in Fedora or any other versions, N2S, this type of versions have this particular command to get back to its previous directory. But in Ubuntu, that is only cd. So this cd, cd dot dot, these are the options or these are the commands available to get back to its previous directory, right? So I'm just quickly do it once again for you people so that you can easily understand it again. So first, to make a directory, mkdir, right? Mkdir CSE, suppose 19. So according to your batch name, CSE 19. I have created a directory. So if after pressing the enter, no error messages this page, then my command have run successfully. And I can go for the next command, right? Now to move to the next part, that is cd CSE 19. I have moved to my next directory, that is CSE 19. Now to get back to its previous directory, only write cd, and now we are back with the previous directory, right? So the basic three command first we have learned. So keep remembering this, because after each lab session, you people need to write whatever we are doing in the class, and you need to submit it to me, right? How you are going to submit, I will tell the procedure in the later part, but I'm telling that keep a note of this particular thing. You will also get the total details in the YouTube after end of the class. So no issue on that. Now suppose I have a file. I want to view that what are the things are available, right? So this command, I hope you people remember that this command ls, right? So this ls, what is the role of this ls actually? That this ls command helps us to list the files, whatever the files are there, folders, directories, whatever the things are there, we can visualize all the things simply by writing the command ls. So this ls command will help us to view all the files and folders, directories that is present in my current directory, right? So all the things will display. So some blue colors we can see, and some things are white, right? So blue and white, it is a combination we can see. So blue are my directories that is present in my current directory. White, that are the files. White, that are the files, directory and files. So these are the two colors describing two things. Blue, that you people can easily understand that. You people can see one CSE 19, right? Here we can see CSE 19, CSE 123. So right, we have just created these two files, these two directories actually, CSE 19 and CSE 123. So you can easily understand that the blue are the directories and white are the normal folder or files that is describing. So ls will help us to get a list of directories and the files that is present in my current directory. Now adding a more option in it, that is ls minus L. L is minus L. So after writing this particular command, ls minus L, we have a description of each file. We have a huge description of each file, right? So if you can look carefully, this particular are my list of directories and the files, and each of these have so can you hear me?
Yes sir.
Okay, so by using this particular command ls minus l, we can visualize all the information at which date, at which particular time, when it is created. So if we look carefully, that in the time November 2, look at this November 2, the CSE 123 and CSE 19 directory was created. That is November 2. The time is displayed here. This is my initial directory, that is CSE lab 2. And what are the permissions we have? That is write, X, WXR, XR, all the things is displayed. Means the total information on this, total information of each directory, each folder, each file, we can have total displayed result in our desktop, in our terminal. So by using simply ls command, we can view the list of directories and the folders and the files. And by using ls minus l, we can visualize each of the total thing. We can visualize each of the total information by using ls minus l. Ls minus l. Okay. Now, the next part, that is suppose nano CSE123.txt. CSE123.txt. Look, I have write a command CSE nano123.txt. And this CSE nano123.txt have shifted us to a new totally page. That is a total new page we have moved into. So this is a editor. This is a text editor file. By using this simply CSE nano CSE.123. So nano is my command. And CSE123.txt, txt is the extension file. CSE123 is my file name. And nano is the command to create a new text file. In the later, but in the down part, we can see there are several options. There are several options available. We can see in this particular part. Get help, write out, where is, replace, read file, exit. So all the things was written, means the options, what are the options available, what we can do, all the things are present here, right? So control X, if I am doing the control X, then I am getting out of that part of the editor part and again back to my terminal. So I by using this control X, we are easily getting back to my terminal. Right, so a very simple command, nano cs123.txt. We can create a new text file, we can go for an editor file where we can write something and then we can save it by using only a control X option. So I will again get into that nano cs123.txt. Okay, one thing, that the link may be end at any time. When the link will be cut, you will rejoin again for the second session of the lab. and we will continue the discussion. So first session can be is going to end at any time. So join for the second session when the link gets cut automatically. Okay. So now again I am writing that nano csc123.txt, and we are then again moved to that terminal, means that editor terminal. This is my editor portion where we can write anything. Okay. So suppose good afternoon. Okay, so I have write it and then I am closing it. Now when I am using this control X option, we have some things is displaying that save modified buffer, answering no will this changes. So whatever the things we are going to do, we are going to do using the command. So when I am using this control X, it will move to it will showing us some options that write Y for yes, write N for no. So we have to write Y. File name to write csc123.txt. All the things I've done. Okay. And we have moved out from the buffer, moved out of the editor part. Now if I again get back into that particular editor section of that particular text file, that is csc123.txt. Now we can see that good afternoon, that particular thing is displayed here. So means we can understand that whatever we have done through the process by creating the editor file, writing something, and then getting out of the option using control X. Using control X, the total process is in a particular shape, and the total process is running successfully. The process is running successfully. So now we have this nano file in our particular path. Now I will first go for this ls, right? In this ls you can see that what are the options are available. Right here we can see all what are the options are available in the ls part. We can visualize. Now let us write that ls again. I have write the ls again. What new you can see, what new with compared to that previous ls command, what new option you can see here?
csc123.txt.
Yes, means what whatever we have done using this nano, using that nano command, nano csc123.txt, using that nano command, that command process have run successfully.